Good morning, children. Welcome you all to Science Online class. In previous video, we have already studied about classification of materials and some properties of materials on the basis of which materials can be classified, like appearance, luster or shine, etc. Today we are going to learn about some other properties of material such as hardness, texture, states of matter, solubility, density, transparency, conductivity of heat, etc. Okay, so let's start with property hardness. Children, different material feels different when we touch them. That means they have different texture. Some materials are hard to compress while other can be compressed very easily. Materials can be classified on the basis of their hardness. Materials or object that are scratched easily are called soft object. Okay, and the materials or object which cannot be scratched easily are called hard object, and the property is called hardness of matter. Okay, so diamond is the hardest naturally occurring substance known to us. A diamond is used for cutting glasses or for drilling. And talcum powder. Talcum powder, which is obtained from soapstone, is the softest substance known to us. Okay. Here 10 substances are given, which are arranged in increasing order of their hardness. First is talc or talcum powder, gypsum, calcite, fluorite, apatite, feldspar, quartz, topaz, corundum or ruby, and last one is diamond. It means talcum powder is the softest substance while diamond is the hardest substance known to us. Okay, now move to the next property of material is states. In general, matter is found in three states: solid, liquid and gases. Solids have definite shape, size and volume. Liquid have definite volume, but they do not have fixed shape, and they acquire the shape of container in which they kept. And gases neither have definite volume nor have definite shape. Both liquid and gases can flow. And three states of matter shows difference in their properties due to the differences in their arrangement of molecule in them. You can see in the picture. The arrangement of the molecule in case of solid, liquid and gases. Okay. The molecules are very closely and tightly packed in solid. There is strong force of attraction between the molecule that binds them together. Thus, solids have definite shape and volume. Their molecules can only vibrate about mean position. This further makes the solid rigid and hard. Okay. In case of liquid, the molecules are less tightly packed. The force of attraction between the molecule is not so strong as solid, and therefore the molecules of liquid can move around within the liquid. That is why they are not rigid and they do not have definite shape. द मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ गैसेस आर फार अपार्ट एंड देर इज हार्डली एनी अट्रैक्शन बिटवीन देम. देयरफॉर द गैस मॉलिक्यूल कैन मूव अराउंड इंडिपेंडेंटली एंड ऑक्यूपाई ऑल द स्पेस अवेलेबल टू देम. हेंस गैसेस डू नॉट हैव एनी फिक्स्ड शेप और वॉल्यूम. यू कैन सी इन द पिक्चर अरेंजमेंट ऑफ द मॉलिक्यूल इन सॉलिड लिक्विड एंड गैस. इन सॉलिड द मॉलिक्यूल्स आर क्लोजली पैक्ड एंड इन लिक्विड द स्पेस इज मोर इन बिटवीन द मॉलिक्यूल्स एज कंपेयर टू सॉलिड एंड इन गैस द मॉलिक्यूल्स आर वेरी फार अपार्ट एंड दे आर हार्डली एनी अट्रैक्शन बिटवीन देम. हेंस द गैसेज डू नॉट हैव एनी fixed shape or volume. Okay, I hope you understood this. Now move to the next property of matter, solubility. Solubility means the ability of the substance to dissolve in liquid is called solubility. The mixture of solute and solvent is called solution. Mixture of solute and solvent is called solution. Okay, now what is solute? The substance which is being dissolved is called solute, and the substance in which solute is dissolved is called solvent, and mixture of solute and solvent is called solution. Solids, liquid and gases dissolve in number of substances, and these substances are called solvent. Water is commonly available solvent. Actually, water causes the solute molecule to separate out and occupy the intermolecular space among the water molecule. Okay, the substances that disappeared when mixed with water are called soluble in water. You can see sugar, when we add sugar in water, sugar completely dissolved in water and the we get the solution transparent and clear solution. So such substances which completely dissolved in water are called soluble substances, and whereas the substances like sand, when we add sand in water, sand cannot dissolve in water, and such kind of substances are called insoluble substance. Sand is insoluble in water. Okay, to explain this solubility of various substances in water, we can do one activity. Children, take the sample of salt, sugar, flour, rice or any other substances like wax, iron nails. Take some glasses, 6 glasses, and put the mark by pasting the strip of paper on the glasses and fill the glasses with the water. Put some of the sample in each glass and stir the content of the glass with the help of the spoon for some time. Now carefully observe the contents of each of the glass and note down your observation in this table. If the sample disappear or its amount is reduced, we can conclude that it has dissolved. Just like salt, sugar is can completely dissolve in water. So we can say that it is soluble in water. Okay, and note down the level of water has increased or decreased or remained the same in case of all the sample that you have taken. Children, this activity can also be extended to other liquid samples such as milk, vinegar lemon juice, mustard oil, coconut oil, paints, etc. The liquids which can completely dissolve in water are called miscible, like lemon, milk, vinegar. You can see in the picture, orange juice is given there. Orange juice is completely dissolved in water, so we can say it miscible. Whereas oil cannot dissolve in water. It float on the water. So we say that it is immiscible in water. Oil is immiscible. Oil float on the water. So we can say that oil is immiscible in water. Children, miscibility of air in water is also very important for aquatic life. Like fishes take oxygen which is dissolved in water through their gills. Water plant also absorb the dissolved oxygen to grow. In cold drinks, mainly contain carbon dioxide gas dissolved in sugar water or in flavored syrup. When we open the bottle, the dissolved carbon dioxide under pressure comes out in the form of bubbles. Okay, now come to the next property of material, density. Children, density means the degree of compactness of substance is called density. And the substances are called dense substance. These are the substances. Take some substances like nails, soap, okay, and plastic caps, etc. So a simple example is, if you have ever tried to mix water and oil. Oil is less dense than water, so it floats on the top. The immiscible substances like oils float, whereas other sink. The substances such as wax, mustard oil, coconut oil or paint float on the surface of water because the density of these substances is lower than that of water. And other substances such as stone, glass, iron nails sink in the water because they have denser they are denser than the water. Okay, means the dense substances can sink and less denser substances than water can float in water. Okay, move to the next property of substance, transparency. Children, why do we use glass panes in windows and showcase? The answer is quite simple. We can see through the glass. We call the glass transparent because of this property. Like wood and metal do not allow the light to pass through them. Therefore, they are called opaque. Okay, the substance which do not allow the light to pass through them are called opaque substance. Example, wood, metal, etc. And in between two transparent and opaque, there is another substance which allow the light to pass through them partially, are called translucent. If the glass surface on the ground and made somewhat rough, then it become translucent. We can also make the paper translucent by applying small amount of oil or grease on the paper. It cannot see through it clearly, but blurred view is obtained. Window panes in our bathroom are normally fitted with translucent glasses. In the engineering industry, ammonia prints are obtained from the translucent tracing drawn on the butter paper. Okay, now come to the next property, conductivity of heat. When we put one end of some of the object in flame, the other end is also get heated. This ability of certain substances to permit the flow of heat through them is called thermal conductivity or conductance of heat. We can see in the picture metal rod in the flame and glass rod. Metal are good conductor. Metal allow the heat to pass through them, but glass do not allow the flame heat to pass through them. So to check the heat conductivity of various substances, we can do one of the activity here. Children, take some substances like metal spoon, wooden spoon. If there is no wooden spoon, you can take wooden pencil, plastic spoon or plastic scale, glass rod, etc. You can take. And boil some water in a small pan. Take that hot water in a beaker. Place the item that you have taken in boiling water in such a way that one end of each item is dipped in the boiling water and other end extend outside the beaker. After 3 to 4 minutes, touch the end of the item extending out of the beaker. Note which one is hot and which one is not hot. Okay, and fill the table given below. Okay, the metal spoon. Metal are good conductor of heat. So that metal spoon got heated. So we can feel hot. But wood is bad conductor. It is not allow heat to pass through them. And such material are called insulator, which do not allow the heat to pass through them are called insulator. The wood is insulator. So it does not got hot. Plastic spoon you can observe and write. If the substance which got heat hot, you can say that good conductor of heat. So metal is good conductor of heat. Wood is bad conductor of heat. Okay. On the basis of this observation, we can conclude that metal are good conductor of heat and wood, plastic, glass are bad conductor of heat. This is the reason why handles of kitchen utensils are made up of wood or bakelite. We often use clothes to pick up the hot utensil from the stove because metal being good conductor and will be too hot to touch with one's bare hand. Liquid and gases can also be the good or bad conductor of heat. Liquid that are good conductor of heat serve as cooling or heating oils in the room heater and coolers. Air is being bad conductor of heat, act as insulator. I said you, insulator means the substance which do not allow heat to pass through them. Heat from our bodies is not conducted to the cold air outside. It remains under our clothes that keeps us warm. Okay, I hope you understood from this activity the conduction of heat through the different substances. Now come to the next property, combustibility. Combustibility means the property of substances विच मेजर द कैपेबिलिटी ऑफ बर्निंग और इग्नाइट. कंबस्टिबिलिटी ऑफ द सब्सटेंसेस इज द केमिकल प्रॉपर्टी एंड विच मेजर इट्स कैपेबिलिटी ऑफ इग्निशन और बर्निंग. द मटेरियल दैट बर्न्स ईजली आर कॉल्ड कंबस्टिबल मटेरियल एंड द मटेरियल विच डू नॉट कैच फायर ईजली आर कॉल्ड नॉन कंबस्टिबल मटेरियल्स. एग्जाम्पल ऑफ कंबस्टिबल मटेरियल आर गिवन हियर सच एज वुड, कोल, लिक्विड पेट्रोलियम गैस एंड केरोसिन आर कंबस्टिबल मटेरियल. दे आर ईजिली फ्लेमेबल. ओके, नेक्स्ट प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ मटेरियल इज मैग्नेटिज्म. इट इज़ द फंडामेंटल प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ सम मटेरियल एंड सम सब्सटेंसेस दैट आर अफेक्टेड बाय मैग्नेटिज्म. मैग्नेटिज्म मैग्नेट्स आर द पीस ऑफ मेटल्स दैट कैन पुल सर्टन टाइप्स ऑफ मेटल टूवर्ड्स इट्सेल्फ एंड द फोर्स ऑफ मैग्नेट इज कॉल्ड मैग्नेटिज्म. चिल्ड्रेन, द मैग्नेट इज अ पीस ऑफ मेटल दैट कैन पुल सर्टन अदर टाइप्स ऑफ मटेरियल्स टूवर्ड्स इट्सेल्फ एंड सच टाइप ऑफ सब्सटेंस आर कॉल्ड मैग्नेट एंड द प्रॉपर्टी आर कॉल्ड मैग्नेटिज्म. इट इज द बेसिक फोर्स इन नेचर. ओके, वन ऑफ द एक्टिविटी हियर टू स्टडी द डायरेक्टिव प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ बार मैग्नेट. टेक वन बार मैग्नेट एंड टाई अ थ्रेड अराउंड इट एज शोन इन द फिगर एंड सस्पेंड द बार मैग्नेट फ्रॉम अ क्लैम्प विद द हेल्प ऑफ द थ्रेड. नोट डाउन द डायरेक्शन विच द मैग्नेट पॉइंट्स. द नॉर्थ पोल ऑफ द मैग्नेट पॉइंट्स टूवर्ड नॉर्थ डायरेक्शन एंड साउथ पोल ऑफ द बार मैग्नेट पॉइंट्स टूवर्ड साउथ डायरेक्शन ऑफ अर्थ. ओके, द नॉर्थ पोल ऑफ द बार मैग्नेट पॉइंट्स टूवर्ड नॉर्थ डायरेक्शन एंड साउथ पोल ऑफ टूवर्ड साउथ डायरेक्शन ऑफ अर्थ. वी कैन फाइंड द डायरेक्शन विद द हेल्प ऑफ द मैग्नेट. अल्टरनेटिवली, इफ वी नो द डायरेक्शंस नॉर्थ एंड साउथ वी कैन डिटरमाइन द कंसर्न पोल ऑफ द बार मैग्नेट. ओके, नाउ कम टू द नेक्स्ट प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ मटेरियल, इलेक्ट्रिकल कंडक्टिविटी. चिल्ड्रेन, द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ मटेरियल्स ओइंग टू विच दे कैन कंडक्ट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी थ्रू देम इज कॉल्ड इलेक्ट्रिकल कंडक्टिविटी. ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ कंडक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी द मटेरियल्स आर टू टाइप्स आर डिवाइडेड इन टू कैटेगरीज सच एज गुड कंडक्टर और एंड बैड कंडक्टर. गुड कंडक्टर मीन्स द सब्सटेंसेस विच कैन कंडक्ट द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी थ्रू देम एट रूम टेम्परेचर आर कॉल्ड गुड कंडक्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. ऑल द मेटल्स लाइक सिल्वर, गोल्ड, कॉपर, स्टील, ऑल द मेटल्स आर द गुड कंडक्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. सिल्वर इज द बेस्ट कंडक्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. एंड द बैड कंडक्टर द सब्सटेंसेस विच कैन नॉट कंडक्ट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी थ्रू देम आर कॉल्ड बैड कंडक्टर्स. ऑल द नॉन मेटल्स सच एज रबर, ग्लासेस, ऑयल, डायमंड, वुड आर द बैड कंडक्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. दीज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड इंसुलेटर्स. बट ग्रेफाइट इज नॉन मेटल दैट कंडक्ट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. इट इज वन ऑफ ग्रेफाइट इज नॉन मेटल. ऑल द मेटल्स आर वेरी गुड कंडक्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. ग्रेफाइट इज नॉन मेटल बट इट कंडक्ट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इन क्रिस्टलाइन स्टेट. चिल्ड्रेन, सम सब्सटेंस डू नॉट अलाउ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी टू फ्लो थ्रू देम एट रूम टेम्परेचर बट अलाउ to flow at high temperature are called semiconductor. See, the substances which allow the electricity to pass through them are good conductor. The substances which do not allow the electricity to pass through them are bad conductor. But some substances do not allow electricity to pass through them at room temperature, but allow at high temperature. Such substances are called semiconductor. For example, silicon and germanium are example of semiconductors. Okay, I hope you understood all these topics well. Okay, that's all for today, children. Good day.